We are gathered here to celebrate one of the life's greatest moments, the joining of two lives, becoming one in a holy covenant with God and one another. This is done before you, your family, and the closest of friends. Seth, I want you to repeat after me. I, Seth, take you, Taylor, to be my wife.
I, Seth, take you, Taylor, to be my wife.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
For better or for worse. For richer or for poorer. In sickness and in health. In the sight of God and these witnesses.
In the sight of God and these witnesses.
I pledge myself to you.
I pledge myself to you.
Forsaking all others.
Forsaking all others.
The marriage will also challenge you in ways that you can't imagine. Just because it's Seth, right? But there will be times when you won't understand Seth and all his complexities, but these will be the times when you as well, your trust in God and your unconditional love commitment to him will prevail. So Seth and Taylor, it is my great pleasure as a minister of the Lord Jesus Christ to pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss your bride. Taylor Brown.
Love doesn't give up. Your commitment today is not only to each other, but to God also.
It's a little awkward when you're the younger brother of the bride as well as the best man, because occasionally right before you go to give your speech, your sister shows up and gives you a whole list of things you can't say about her and her new husband. So,
Seth, speaking from experience, you have gained the greatest best friend you could have ever asked for. She will cry with you, laugh at you, and most importantly, love you.
Seth, it has been Tandy and I's pleasure to get to know you and to appreciate you for the man you are. And for the man that will take care of Taylor. So, please join me in wishing Taylor and Seth every happiness possible and a long and joyful life together as husband and wife into the next chapter in your fairy tale. Cheers.